10 miles north of Shandy, on the track to Talkeetna, Roadmaster Hugh Evans is on his daily track inspection. He faces a never-ending battle to keep his section of the railroad open, no matter what Mother Nature might throw at him. If he does spot any problems, he'll have to stop the passenger train, leaving Shandy stranded.
We've had lots of rain here the past couple of days, really playing havoc on the track out here, causing the water to flow over the rail and freezing at night. We got a train coming by within the next couple of hours through this area, headed north, so we need to make sure everything's safe for their passage and get her done. Oh, shoot. I'm gonna get out and take a look at this spot. It's not looking good. Okay, I've got a problem here. I'm looking at the ice buildup along the rail. Right now it's an inch, 2 inches higher than the head of the rail. We got to get it dug down below the base of the rail.
When it rains during warmer periods of the day, water pours down the mountains. It pools in ditches by the tracks, where at night it freezes solid. If too much water builds up, concrete like ice can grow over the rails, blocking the tracks completely if it's not dug back.
You could derail a train as it's going through here, so I'm really concerned about this. Hey, Evans, Todd, over.
On five, over.
This ice has definitely gotten out of hand here, so we need to come up here and take care of this spot.
Roger.
Yeah, roger that. Be pretty slick out here today.
We need to get this one taken care of, over.
Sounds like a job for the dream team.
At Hugh's base in Talkeetna, Todd Robbins and Walt Hand are loading up an excavator to head south to dig out the ice that's endangering the tracks.
This here's an excavator, weighs 44,150 pounds. That ain't including my fat ass. There we go. You got her, buddy. It takes a certain caliber to do this kind of job, you know? It's like the true SEAL team task force up here. Punch it out and get them through. It's probably about 30 below.
At least it's warm and not windy.
Air Evans to Walt Hand, over.
Walt to you, channel 5, over.
Get up here. I'll see you on the site and then we'll brief, over.
Roger. About half miles to go there.
Got a crew coming up right now. Got a potential for a derailment right here. Just need to get it done. We got a train coming by this area, so we're under a little bit of a time crunch right here, so we need to do what we can to make it safe for them there and dig it back.
Roger that.
Really like working with Todd.
Just another day in paradise.
We hunt and fish together. You know, we take and hang out.
On the railroad, he looks out for me when it comes to hunting. I make sure he don't get lost and he comes back to camp safe. So it works out.
This is dangerous for Todd, so we gotta be real careful here.
Rainwater has flooded ditches alongside the tracks and frozen solid. If more water pools on top, the ice could grow across the tracks, blocking them. Todd needs to dig it out fast. Balanced precariously on the flatbed, he maneuvers his excavator so he can reach the ice. If he extends the arm too far, the 22-ton machine will tip over.
I've seen an excavator go off a flatbed, and it's not a pretty picture. You lay one of these over the right way, you can crush and kill yourself instantly. What is this hard?
Getting into some hard ice here.
Man, the ice is the toughest that I've ever been. Doing my best, but it's a little extreme today.
Gentle, brother, gentle. Just a little bit less on the jerking around there, please, over.
Easy for you to say, you ain't running the excavator.
Always one thing is another.
Be careful there, Todd. You know, escalator's sliding around a lot on the cart, so just take little bites. We don't need to take big bites. We'll try to tear the world up right here.
Let me do my job.
That boy scares me. It's a little bit slick on the deck, so I'm out here.
Whoa!
Ice is built up so close to the tracks that it must be removed before the passenger train can pass. But in the rush to clear it away, the unsecured excavator is in danger of falling off the flatbed.
We're messing up here a little bit. We're sliding around. Go ahead and shut it down. We'll cross-chain it right now.
Okay.
Hugh and his crew need to chain down the 22-ton machine to the flatbed to make it safe.
What do you want to do here, Walt?
Cross-chain from that track to the same hole.
Right.
And this track to that other hole.
Okay. Hand me that one.
We got a train that's going to be in our location here in the next 45 minutes, so we need to get this taken care of and dig this ice out.
Boy, it was just scary. This thing almost sliding off on the edge like that.
Yep. Just be extremely careful.
Well, hopefully that'll do her, Walt. Looks pretty good.
Okay, we'll give that a try.
Hugh's on my case a little more than normal today, you know. He's all worried, you know. They're looking out for me.
You copy there, Todd, over.
Yeah,
I am. Okay, yeah, I just don't need to have any more accidents there, please, over.
Roger that, Hugh.
Yeah, that definitely looks better there, Todd. Appreciate it, over.
It feels a lot better.
Todd needs to clear more than 200 tons of ice before the passenger train can pass through here. Over a winter season, rail crews can remove around 200,000 tons of ice to keep the trains rolling in Alaska.
We're in a real race against time right now, so we gotta pick it up here a little bit. How's it looking there, Todd? Over.
Looking pretty good.
Appreciate the help there, over.
You got it, Hugh. Good to have a good roadmaster looking after it.
Todd.
Let's call it quits right there, over.
Sounds good to me. I'm on it.
Had Mother Nature throw us a curveball this morning with the ice coming down to the track. We came out here and took care of the problem. Should be on time for our trains to get through here. Good job.
You bet. Every day is a challenge. I feel great, you know, we've gotten a mountain of ice move. We got the trains to be able to come through now and everything, and life is gonna be good.
It's coming.
With the ice cleared, the passenger train can pass through to pick up Nancy.